to look swiftly into the thing that says, this same Jesus. Somebody say, this same Jesus.
This same Jesus.
This same Jesus.
This same Jesus.
I'm going to run through a very few texts and points. Point number one says, from Galilee to Golgotha. Galilee to Golgotha. Galilee to Golgotha. Golgotha means a place of skull where Jesus Christ was crucified. Galilee to Golgotha. And under that we have the triumphant entry. The triumphant entry. And under it as well, number two, we have the trial of the cross. The trial of the cross. And we have the resurrection power. And point number two says, grace. From grass to grace. Grass to grace. And under that we have from death to surplus. And we have from sickness to death. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to go through into that. As we've read in the text, let's look at it one by one. The text that we read is we read, so we're not going to read everything again. We want to focus on some sudden and beautiful points there. Acts chapter 2, verses 36. It says, therefore, let all Israel be assured of this. God has made this Jesus. God has made what? This Jesus. God has made this Jesus, whom you crucified, both Lord and Messiah. This same Jesus that you crucified, God has made him Lord and Messiah. Let's turn our Bible quickly, flip a little back to Acts chapter 1. Acts chapter 1, verses 11. Acts chapter 1, 11. It says, men of Galilee, they say, why do you stand here looking unto the sky? This same Jesus, whom has been taken up from you unto heaven, will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven. This same Jesus. This same Jesus. Look at from Galilee to Golgotha. Galilee to Golgotha. You know, when a child is born, we say probably the son is a male child. There is a celebration in the house. Neighbors and friends will come to celebrate with the family. So they deal with Jesus. And the time came that the child was growing. Perhaps in the process of his growing up, his father was a carpenter. Some people asked the father to fix a chair for them, and he fixed the chair for them. And Jesus Christ carried the chair. Yeshua, as we call him, Yeshua will carry the chair and deliver it to that person. And they tell them, this is your change. And they tell them, oh, don't worry, keep the change. Yeshua, buy Akara on your way home. Yeshua will run, thank you, we buy the Akara and go home. Now Yeshua grew up, and Yeshua is talking as God. His son that he gave birth to, now grew up. In the house before, you are the one in charge of praise and worship, of money devotion. And now the child that you gave birth to, the child is just 7. And the child is telling money, I'm taking over every money devotion. And when the child is taking over every money devotion, although your ego is there, but you know that the power of God is present when the child is taking over money devotion. The child taking over money devotion by breaking the word of God down, comparing spiritual things with spiritual things. You know this, but your ego is there. I am the father, you know. I am the mother, you know. Before you were born, we've been doing it. I've been taught for 48 years. This is what they did to Jesus. Where are you coming from? The son of David, the son of Joshua, the son of Joseph, the son of Mary. Where are you coming from? We knew where you were growing up. And this is why when he was triumphant entering, I'm giving you from Galilee to Golgotha. He was from Galilee in Nazareth. But it was entry into Jerusalem, a triumphant entry. And everybody was rejoicing. You know, why they were rejoicing is, Isaiah told them in Isaiah 9:6, that a king shall come that will carry on the throne of David, and the kingdom will be upon his shoulder. He will rule mightily. And they say, hallelujah, the king is coming. Now he came, he introduced himself as a king. And when he was entering into Jerusalem, they said, wow, this is the king. He is coming to take over the Roman power and the Roman Empire. And he was saying, Hosanna, Hosanna to the God Most High. They said, yeah, go see the demonstration. In Matthew 21, verses 1 to 11. Matthew 21, verses 1 to 11. There was still the Hosanna. We're going to see the demonstration from Galilee to Golgotha. Don't forget that even the disciples, look at that in Acts chapter 1 as well. Acts chapter 1, they asked him, Jesus. Acts chapter 1, verses 6. Then they gathered around him and asked him, Lord, are you in this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? So their focus is different. That when the king comes, what he's going to do, when the Messiah comes, he's going to deliver them from the hands of the Roman Empire, Roman ruling. But when he came, his own mind was different. He started talking about kingdom of heaven. They said, no. Before we get there, let's take over the kingdom of hell first. And he said, no, I rule the kingdom of heaven on earth. Amen? Yeah. Amen? Yeah. Are you with me, brethren?
Yes, sir.
From Galilee to Golgotha. I'm telling you what happened when they were saying Hosanna, and when the disciples were asking him, take over. They are tired of the oppression of the Roman Empire. And they expect a king is coming. And after they shout, Hosanna, Hosanna. Monday, Hosanna, they are waiting. Tuesday, they are waiting. Wednesday, they are waiting. Thursday, they are waiting. Month, years, nothing is happening. See what they did. The trial of the cross. John 19. Let's go to John 19. The gospel according to St. John. Chapter 19, verse 17 and 18. We are talking about this same Jesus. This same Jesus. This same Jesus. Don't chapter 19, verse 17 and 18. Anyone find it?
Yes, sir.
Alright, go read for us, please.
And he, bearing his cross,
yes, ma'am,
went out to a place called the place of his fall, which is called in Hebrew Golgotha, where they crucified him, and two others with him, one of either side and Jesus in the center. Now Pilate wrote a title and put it on the cross, and the writing was Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews.
Then you see, the same people that were shouting Hosanna, and after they had expected this same Jesus to take over the Roman Empire, and they did it. It's too delayed. It's wasting their time. And the next moment, they turned around him and said, crucify him. Crucify him! Crucify him! I can say his thing. People that are saying crucify him, they are in two categories. And I asked people, I said, do you think Judas is actually a bad person? Judas Iscariot is actually a bad person? You might say yes. Theologically, we say no. Because Judas, the same thing as his people, the same thing as his disciples, hear what they ask him. When are you going to return the kingdom? When are you going to talk about the kingdom? So that we can be the ruler. So that we can have rest. So that we don't pay tax anymore. So that we can rule in the kingdom. The same thing Judas was doing. And but he went further in his home. He says, okay, he's wasting time. And I know he's got the power. So when I put him on the spot, he's going to demonstrate his power. And from then we're going to take over. You get what I'm saying? Amen?
Amen.
Judas, in his mind, theologically, according to the script, according to the text, the words that are left behind, Judas wasn't really a bad person. Why would he regret at the end then? Why would he return the money then? Why would he cry bitterly then? Do you know if he's gone to heaven or not? You will say, no, he can't go to heaven. Do you know? Because he wept bitterly and repented. Because what he expected is what happened. Let's move further. And he says, crucify him. Among these people, there are two groups, as I said. One group that will be expecting him to take over the kingdom is not taking over the kingdom. The other group that will be seeing him, this little boy that was born in our presence, is speaking as if he is the Lord. And when he's comparing himself to be God, oh, that pissed them off totally. These are the two groups that say, crucify him anyway, it's worth nothing. Brethren, this same Jesus was bruised, beaten, and later crucified. And when he died, there was an absolute silence, a gross darkness, fear, grief. The disciples and the lost hope, and went back to their various occupations where he has called them out from. Brethren, the same people that says, Hosanna, the same people says, crucify him. And this same Jesus, they crucify him. Brethren, just like it says, if they are doing this to a tree that's wet, they are doing this to me, I want you to know you. Brethren, Jesus says, if they are doing this thing to me, I want you to know you. And see, we are in the world, but we are not of the world. Those that say, Hosanna, oh sister, you look so beautiful. That one that is saying, what's wrong with her anyway? Those that say, this brother, you look so nice. That one that says, it's probably too much. I said, Hosanna, Hosanna. And listen, Jesus, they say, crucify him. And totally, they crucify Jesus. Brethren, truly, they crucify Jesus. And Jesus died. And when Jesus died, the body did not have any child anymore. When Jesus died, the disciples lost hope. They went back to their various locations. When Jesus died, the lambs, they lose hope. They know that all people remain like that forever. When Jesus died, the blind, when they heard that he's dead, because the blind Bartimaeus, when they heard about him, they cried unto him. But now the blind do not hear about him in the street anymore. So they knew that he's dead, and they knew that they would remain blind forever. When Jesus died, those that are looking unto him, they lost their hope. And they seal up the grave, and they put stone around it, and they send soldiers to be around him. Jesus is dead. Everything is dark. And we're told that between the book of Malachi and the book of Matthew, there was a total darkness of 400 years. Between the book of Malachi and Matthew, no prophecy, no prophets. Of course, when there's no prophecy, where are you going to be a prophet? No revelation, no inspiration. No, thus says the Lord. Because everywhere was in total darkness. Jesus died. Why are you a Christian if Jesus is dead? You know, we were told about the people that went to Jerusalem and they went to research. They said in the tomb that Jesus Christ was buried, when in there, they carved their tomb while they are still alive. And the owner of the tomb, they rented it to for them to bury Jesus. And we're told that the woman asked the husband, why can you give us the tomb that we buried for ourselves? How can you give it out? This is ridiculous. What's wrong with you? And the man told the wife, he says, don't worry, it's not going to stay long. Amen. The man told the woman, don't worry, it's not going to stay long. Because they believe Jesus Christ died. And see what happened, brethren. See what happened, brethren. We have a resurrection power. We have the resurrection power. We have the resurrection power that went into the grave and bring out this same Jesus. He brought out the same Jesus. And now we have hope in him. And now we have hope in him. And now we have hope in him. Because resurrection power have brought out this Jesus from the grave. Let's look at Mark 16, verses 1 to 6. Gospel of Mark 16, 1 to 6. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of Jesus, of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go and anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other, "Will we roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb?" Now they are worried already that we're going to roll the tomb away. But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. And they entered the tomb, and they saw the young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. "Don't alarm," he said. "You are looking for Jesus, the Nazarene, who was crucified. And he's risen. And he is what?"
"Not here."
"Hello?"
"Not here."
"Hello?"
"He's not here."
"Hello?"
"He's not here."
"Hello?"
"He's not here."
So the man that came back is still down. Jesus, the same Jesus that died, the same Jesus is risen, the same Jesus is alive, the same Jesus is presently here. I have a cancer, I have an engagement with somebody yesterday when we went out, and I during our conversation was telling me that yes, in their book they have those prophets, those names and all that. And I was asking various questions. You know, those people, we have to ask for the wisdom of God to be able to answer the questionnaire, not the question. The questionnaire, not the question. So I was able to ask him some questions. And he says they have a lot of prophets in their book, and those prophets are dead and they are not coming back. Guess what, brethren? Only one person is coming back, and that is Jesus. It is in their book that is coming back. And I told him, why don't you then believe in the Lord Jesus Christ? He that is dead and is coming back. And I told him, go and look for it. Go and search about it. Go and have a talk about it. Why are you not believing on the person that died and the third day he resurrected? And it's only him that is coming back. My father is dead. I told him, my father is dead. He's not coming back. In the Bible, we have a prophet that are dead. They are not coming back. But just one person is there and is coming back. The power of resurrection. The power of resurrection. It says it cannot lose its authority. It cannot lose its authority. The power of resurrection. Amen. It is Jesus. It is Jesus in my soul. So when I touch the hem of his garment makes me whole. Brother, Jesus is here in our midst today. That same Jesus that resurrected is here in our midst today. I have a message I was preparing to preach today, but when they got to the about 3 days ago, everything changed when I was studying, when I was waiting upon the Lord. And I was giving this to present to the people of God. That same Jesus that you thought that he was dead, the same Jesus is alive. Let your fear die in the faith of Jesus. Let your fear die in the faith of Jesus. The same Jesus that died many years ago, the same Jesus resurrected on the third day, and the same Jesus is here today. When you are going to work, think about that same Jesus that is with you and your family, whatever you are going through. Think about that same Jesus that is with you. If you can do it before, you can do it now. Whatever you are going through, brethren, think about that same Jesus in your academy. I need you here. That Jesus is wisdom of God. That same Jesus, when you are going to school, take him along with you. Take him along with you. When you are going to university, take Jesus with you. Ask him to be with you. When you wake up in the morning, ask Jesus to be with you. Our spiritual sister as well yesterday, she said, I do go to church. I said, why you stop going to church? He said, I go sometimes. I said, why? He said, because I'm scared. And I'll be able to explain to him. I'm telling you, brethren, when you have that same Jesus, you have nothing to be afraid of. Get into the bus and don't be afraid. Take the same Jesus inside the bus with you. And if you hear, like said the apostles, to go further. And when they were going further on the boat, they were scared. When they were stormed, and when they were stormed, they took Jesus with them. And they asked Jesus, wake up because you are with us. And when he woke up, he said to the storm, stay still. When you are going on the train, take Jesus with you. When you fly on the air, take Jesus with you. Because the Holy Ghost is the one that is in control of the air. The Holy Ghost, it moves like the water. When you are on the boat, take the Jesus with you. Because you have power and authority over the sea and the wind. We are talking about this same Jesus. Say the same Jesus. This same Jesus. Let's go to the grace, grass to grace. Taking us from grass to grace. This same Jesus can take us from grass to grace. This same Jesus can take us from oppression to success. This same Jesus can escalate and change our life. Brethren, please, in this moment, I want you to pray on your seat. I want you to pray with power, because if you don't pray with power, I'm going to ask you to stand up. Pray and say, Jesus,
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 converts every problem in my life to success.
Jesus,
Jesus, convert every sorrow to success.
Jesus,
convert every challenge to testimony. Pray, 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 and watch us, guys. That same Jesus. That same Jesus, that same Jesus, that same Jesus is here today. Is here today. Is here today. That same Jesus. Pray then. Don't you hear what requires some today? In the hymn. It says, oh happy day. Oh happy day. He has taught you to wash and to pray and to live rejoicing every day. He's talking about that same Jesus. Who else can tell you to live rejoicing every day? If not the same Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, this same Jesus is in this church.
Yes.
This same Jesus is your house.
Yes.
This same Jesus
is at the workplace.
Yes. This same Jesus
is on the journey.
It's the same Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Grass to grace. From death to surplus. 1 Kings 17. 1 Kings 17. 7 to 15. 1 Kings 17. If you are there, simply read 1 Kings 17, 7 to 8. Yes, sir.
And when he came to the gate of the city,
yes,
behold, the widow woman was there gathering of peace.
Yes.
And he came to her, and he called to her, and said, fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in the vessel that I may drink. And as she was going to fetch it, he called to her, and said, bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in thy hand. And she said, as the Lord thy God liveth,
yes,
I have not a cake, but a handful of meal in the barrel, and a little oil in the cruse.
Yes.
And behold, I am gathering 2 sticks, that I may go in and dress it for me and my son,
yes,
that we may eat it
that
and
he
die.
And, die. Yes, sir.
And Elijah said unto her, fear not,
yes,
go and do as thou hast said,
yes,
but make me thereof a little cake first,
yes,
and bring it unto me, and after make for thee and thy son.
Yes.
For thus said the Lord God of Israel,
yes,
the barrel of meal shall not wait, neither shall the cruse of oil fail, until the day that the Lord sendeth rain upon the earth.
Yes.
And she went and did according to the saying of Elijah.
Yes, sir.
And she,
listen to this.
And she and he and her house did eat many days.
Amen.
And the barrel of meal wasted not, neither did the cruse of oil fail, according to the word of the Lord which he spake by Elijah.
Amen. The word, please, let's see the text. The word of the Lord
the word of the Lord, the word of the Lord, the word of the Lord, the word of the Lord. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. In him all things were made, and without him nothing on earth were made. For the women, the flower, the bread, the baby, the coconut, everything were made by the power of the word. And it says the word was with God. It's talking about Jesus. And Elijah was telling the woman, according to Jesus, I am telling you that you move from death to surplus.
Amen.
It says, according to Jesus, from God, I am telling you that you move from death to surplus.
Amen.
You see, there was a famine in the land. And this woman has no husband. May I tell you this quickly? That the land of Israel, if you have no husband, your household cannot be counted in census. If you have no husband, if you have no male that is mature in your family, your household, when they are sharing something, or government is giving out any aid or give, your household is not partaker in it. So you can see how the story of this woman is so pathetic. So God sent Elijah to her. And he says, according to Jesus, we are talking about this same Jesus. And Elijah, what he did was, he released Jesus to the woman. He said, woman, what you need is not for you to be moody. It's not for you to be sorrowful. It's not for you to be pitying yourself. It's not for you to regret. It's not for you to be filled with fear. It's not for you to think you are going to die after you eat the last meal. But woman, what I'm telling you, according to Jesus, because of Jesus, give me this food, and I will give you Jesus, and Jesus will multiply your life, and you will remain never in death. And the woman says, according to, hear what she said, according to your God, according to the word of your God, he said, according to Jesus, I will give it to you. And the woman gave it to Elijah. Literally, she gave it to Elijah, and Elijah gave it out Jesus. And she went back, she went to food, prepared the food for Elijah. Elijah was eating, he was looking at her. We're going to die, you're enjoying yourself. And Elijah was saying in his mind, nah, you're not going to die, because I've already given you Jesus. I will supply you all your need. And the woman, she went back home. We're going to die anyway. When she got back home, nonsense. She kicked the pot. Oil was boiling down. She said, what is going on? She took her mouth out. Oil was flowing. Jesus is in the house. The same Jesus is here today, brethren, to supply all your need, to move you from credit card to debit card. The same Jesus is here today to move you from credit card to surplus. That same Jesus. I'm telling you that I have a message for today. But God is giving this message for somebody to remind you about the same Jesus. When you first receive Jesus, you know that he can do anything, everything, and anything. But now, perhaps, you are losing hope in him. You think, oh yes, if I'm going to work, Jesus can preserve me. I go and come back. If I sleep, my alarm will ring. Jesus can wait me for that. But this problem is too much for Jesus. This problem is too big for Jesus. Oh, come on. I am here to remind you and tell you that nothing, absolutely nothing, is too big for Jesus. Because the same Jesus yesterday, the same Jesus today. Amen. Let's go from sickness to health. From sickness to health. Someone can be sick physically, you can be sick spiritually, and you can be sick financially. From sickness, Acts for persons, I'm going to finish here. Acts chapter 3. Very, very powerful, interesting here. Thank you very much, sir. Very, very interesting here. Acts chapter 3, we found it, fire on. Acts chapter 3, verses 6 to 8.
Okay.
Oh, hold on, sir, hold on, sir.
Okay.
Peter, can you imagine how big Peter? Peter, some days ago, that small baby. Do you know Jesus? No, 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 no. I don't know Jesus. Don't tell me that. Peter was there. Another woman came. Hello, sir. It seems I've seen you with Jesus. No. What? Please don't go by me. Don't go by me. And Peter ran away. Go on, sir. What is Peter saying now? What gives you that boldness?
Then Peter. Filled with the Holy Ghost.
Eh?
Said unto them.
Peter, no.
Ye ruler of the people and elders of Israel. If we this day be examined of the good deeds.
Yes, sir.
To be so the impotent man.
Yes, sir.
By what means?
What means?
Made whole.
Mm-hmm.
Be it known unto
be
you
known.
And to all the people of Israel. That by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth,
be it known.
Who he crucified.
Yes, sir.
Whom God raised from the dead.
Yes, sir.
Even by him does this man.
Yes, sir.
Stand here before you whole.
Amen. Be it known to you. This man, we are looking at them. He wanted to receive something from them. And they looked at him as well. Brethren, please look at me. And they looked at him as well. And the man was expecting. And they said to the man, we know you are expecting money. But listen, man, we don't have money. What we have, we shall give to you. Brethren, what do you have to offer to the world? Are you giving to them what they're giving to you? They give you money, you give them money. Nah. What we have, we shall give to you. And I said to him, in this name, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, rise up and work. And when you get to the next verse that we read, in that chapter 4, and people are saying, people are angry. Can you imagine people have a weekend in life? A man of God was ministering in Nigeria. You see, when he was ministering powerfully in the crusade, a lady was on a wheelchair. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon him and told him to raise his hand to that lady and ask her to rise up in the name of Jesus. As soon as the man of God put his hand to the lady jumped up from the wheelchair. Everybody shouted hallelujah. And the whole house was filled with joy. And the next day, the brethren came to the man of God. He said, man of God, you are so wonderful. Oh, bless God for your life. Hallelujah. You are so good. But man of God, this boy, this lady, she's breadwinner of our house. You got two choices. It's either you take her back to the seat or you begin to feed the family. It's either you send her back to the wheelchair or you start to feed the family. Look at the wicked world that we are living in. What can save us from this wicked world? If not for Jesus. Nobody wants a business to rise if not for Jesus. Nobody wants a children to rise to the glorious place if not for Jesus. Nobody wants a destiny to come forth if not for Jesus. This woman has been there and he has been begging. Nobody was able to help him until the apostles came to help him. And they came to him in the name of Jesus. And they said, we have nothing, but what we have, we give to you.